Young sea scums post. Bottle after bottle after bottle out sent cold filled.
Let's go.
And her arm does not look normal either. It looks like an alien arm.
Yeah, and this looks like a giant butterfly.
And what is that? That looks like a giant mosquito, bro. Where are they at? Have you ever seen that movie Kong? Those insects were hideous, man. That gave me nightmares.
I've never seen that movie.
When they fall in that pit, Kong, the King Kong movie?
Yeah.
When that thing starts freaking, like, eating that dude's freaking leg, like, little by little with the teeth like this, and then just, like, eventually it's the whole freaking face, and then just starts freaking crawling over. Oh, man. You haven't seen that?
No.
The bugs that were trying to suck their blood was, like, big-ass leeches and shit.
What would I type in to see that?
That's why, I would say, well, it's got Jack Black in it. So, Jack Black...
I did see that movie. You mean King Kong Skull Island?
Yeah, that one.
Dude, I rented that game, too. They made, you know, like back in that time when they made a video game of every movie?
Yeah,
so I remember renting it.
Rent the movie, and then the game was in the game section.
Yeah.
Blockbuster, bro.
That was too rich for me. I was a Hollywood video kid.
Me too. I was in that video store over there on First and Clinton.
Bro, I was on the video store and that on Butler and Orange, not Butler and Orange, but like Butler Video Centro. Do you remember that place? That place, dude, that was my spot right there.
Those had that room with the curtain.
Yep.
But Blockbuster, you know, you go to Blockbuster, ain't no room with no curtain in that one.
Yeah.
True. Yeah, the insects or giant insect pit. There you go, bruh.
Insect pit.
Yeah, I think it's like Kong Insect Pit. Look.
Hey, is that... That's...
That's Gollum. Gollum? Oh, Smeagol. They're going to make a movie about Gollum, the Lord of the Rings lore movie series based on the Smeagol. Yeah. You have the volume up? This is where they fell or something in the crack. And then this bullshit happens. This is why we shouldn't go to another planet, because we're going to run into this shit if we go to another planet. Our human race did not evolve around other planets. We evolved in this one, right?
Yeah.
So we came the top, you know, top of the food chain kind of thing over there at another planet. There's no knowing. Fucking 4-foot tarantulas are there, okay? Do you really want to go there and be the first one to get eaten alive by one of those? No, I don't. Do you?
The world isn't fit. Basically, that world doesn't fit us. Like,
no.
Because it we weren't Kong. There
it,
ever.
Obviously, it fits Kong, right? Like, he survived because obviously these insects are not meaningless.
And he's a giant monkey.
And he's a giant
gorilla.
Yeah, just like us. We're, you know, to ants, right? Like, or even real spiders.
That's true.
Huge. But this guy.
Have you seen, you know, do you like Adrian Brody? The guy that first appeared in the first, right here in the scene? Adrian Brody, yeah. He's in that movie Splice.
Yeah.
Where he, like, finds an alien or he has, like, an alien or something and he ends up, like, he fucks it because it's hot and it has, like, boobs and stuff like that.
I remember. It was a Sliver? What the hell was that movie name?
I think it was Splice.
Splice. Yeah.
Him, this guy. He has sex with an alien. And I know he wants to have sex with all these little insects.
Nah. Then this guy was like,
oh my god.
Right here. Fuck that shit. These things are like.
Yeah, it looks like my dude, uncircumcised.
Look at this bad. Look at this. This is bad. Just leave. Dude, your friend's dead. You're going to get fucked up. Oh no. Yeah, you definitely want one of those. Like right on your neck. I don't even want those real size, man. Like regular size that we got over here in this planet.
Yeah.
Those are those water beetle bugs that are super annoying.
Super annoying.
Oh, dude, look at this. Are you kidding?
Fuck, dude. I'm like cringing inside.
Dude, I'm telling you.
Oh, Jack Black wants him dead, huh?
Yeah. Jack's gonna kill Rambo right here.
That's a losing battle. You gotta just run.
Yeah. You know why those holes are there, right? There's a reason.
There's a spot. It's a spider nest.
The fucking that's a scorpion.
Whoa.
The size of a car. Yeah, I don't want scorpions the size of a car. Oh shit. Here we go. Nope. And it's over.
Oh my god, dude. This is terrible.
Dude, this? How do you escape that? Like, he has, they have 2-3 layers of teeth.
Yeah.
And then they just start fighting over his parts, body parts. Just, yeah. Just shoot me at that point, bro. I don't want to get eaten by that. Look at this. Oh, you got a Tommy gun? You barely take it out?
I know, huh? This whole time?
Yeah, you're supposed to do that when they were approaching you, not when they're fucking already swarmed on top of you. And you're going to shoot somebody with that shit. Fuck around and blow that guy's head off instead of the insect.
Damn, he's pretty good at shooting.
Look at this dude. Swinging that shit.
How did he not shoot him once?
Got the wrong guy shooting. Can you imagine the welt that freaking insect would leave on your neck biting you like that?
Yeah, it's...
tumor size. Look at this thing. He's eating his face. Or trying to.
I guess they're pretty goddamn strong, though. I would say, I feel like you could still rip their arms off and stuff, but probably not. They're pretty big.
Well, you gotta fight them without, you know, allowing them to eat your face. Oh, hell no, bro.
So what happens? They obviously die, right? Or does King Kong come and save them?
Yeah.
There's no way out of this. There's just no way.
Something like that. They are, yeah, this got really ugly. How many fucking tarantulas they got?
Oh, that's still not gonna be enough to do anything.
Bro, you can have a limited ammo and still be, like, screwed right here.
Yeah, you'll still lose, cause...
There are way more insects than bullets. This is a movie, but those one bullets would have ran out.
One man army, yeah, he has an infinite ammo glitch.
And I don't think insects that big are gonna be affected by little lead like this. It'll hurt them, but they ain't gonna stop attacking you. It's actually gonna just anger them.
Yeah.
you'd really be overwhelmed.
Yeah, I think it was Khan.
Because he wouldn't, even when I used to watch Tailspin, which is also the animated version of Jungle Book, like a spinoff that they did. Did you ever see that show, Tailspin?
Huh. Oh, Tailspin? Dude. Yeah, I did.
I was like, come on, man. I'm losing you.
I know, yeah. What do you know about?
Yeah, it was Khan. They could see that tiger. Because then Tailspin, the tiger, he's like this giant CEO executive.
Oh, Shere Khan.
And Baloo, yeah, Khan. And then Baloo, he's like this pilot. This he was like a delivery driver. He was a... like, he would deliver packages in his plane, and he had, like, double engine.
Yeah, I do remember. That's like the theme song, right? It's like, something and another tailspin, or something like that.
And then Louie ran a fucking bar.
That's cool. Dude, we should watch an episode of Tailspin.
Yeah. Okay.
Head. Let's see.
The intro theme song is hilarious.
Another tailspin.
the pilots they're like straight up. They had like Hispanic voices in them, like they were always protecting the borders so they wouldn't come through.
Bro, what the fuck? What is he like? You said he's like a delivery Amazon delivery guy by plane, but people want to kill him.
Yeah, that's the mechanic.
Why is everyone trying to kill him?
Because they're pirates. These are pilot pirates. Oh. So they try to. They'll steal his cargo.
Oh.
Yeah, and then you got the people in charge of the cargo, which is Khan, his money, his company.
Oh, yeah, I remember this show, but I didn't really watch it.
Yeah, Louie, man, he's the bartender. That's where Baloo would go chill out at.
It's cool.
Let's get some drinks before the trip.
This is the best theme song Dark of all time.
Darkwing Duck, man, that's funny.
You know, all these shows, then they were so before my time, kind of, but I remember them, that's all, you know what I mean? But they were so cool to me, like Street Sharks and stuff like that. Like, man, I thought that was the coolest thing ever.
Street Sharks.
They looked awesome. They're like ripped sharks that wear like cut off jeans. And
they were all like fucking bulk.
Yeah.
They looked like they did roids, bro.
Steroids. And Ninja Turtles were buff as fuck, too, kind of.
They were lean.
They were lean.
Fighting machine. Remember? Lean, mean, green fighting machine.
Yeah.
April O'Neil was hot, bro. That was my first waifu, homie.
Everybody always says that, but was she?
And the original one, she was.
She had that
one piece suit.
Or, yeah, it's like all yellow or whatever.
Yeah, jump or like overall suit kind of thing. A little bit tight around certain areas.
Yeah.
A little accentuated for the kids.
I'm trying to find one from the old...
right there?
1990. But I want to see an actual still from the cartoon.
Let's see. Yeah, it's a couple right there.
I guess like this, huh?
Was it Channel 8 News?
Yeah, or something like that. Let me show you the real hottest girl... This was the waifu right here, bro.
Oh, this guy.
Rescue Rangers?
That's too innocent for me to pick on like that, man. Yeah, Rescue Rangers was the bomb, man.
She is the bomb.
Montgomery Jack, man. He was that fiend for the cheese.
What do you think now? What do you think of this?
Hey, man, if I was Dale or freaking Chip...
If I was Dale.
I think Dale would be ahead of the game right there.
Yeah.
Dale had the charisma. She was the mechanic, huh? She was their boss.
Now what? What's the verdict?
What was her name again?
Gadget?
Yeah. That's funny.
Bro, look at these beautiful little kiss lips, bro. Damn.
Man.
What if your wife comes in or something? How are you watching?
Right there.
What the fuck?
What is this? What did you draw?
The real Ninja Turtles? I put in the real Ninja Turtles.
Not the real. What is that?
Guys.
Horrible.
They look weird.
Meatball. My sister invited us to eat meatball soup. What? But not regular meatballs, man. It's like albondigas.
A meatball,
traditional OG stuff,
bro. You probably just ate just one big ass meatball with nothing on it. That's it.
Nah, this is pretty good. My sister went. Wow. You got one?
Oh,
what was that one?
This that put the real Power Rangers. There's like fucking 10 of them.
Oh man,
it looks weird. What the hell?
Okay.
So anyway, so I got it.
Let's see.
Hey, see what I wrote right here.
Let's see. Write a rap about a guy who went to Harvard, not got a good job, and married a good woman, and only had one kid, and died of natural causes with his family and friends at his deathbed. Oh, yeah. I'm trying to see, because I think I need to increase the screen size. Hold on.
I told her to write this. Look. Write me a short song about a woman who's been abused, but a stranger asks her who did this to her, and he finds the abuser and kills him. Now the man spends his time in jail forever. And then it says, I'm sorry, but I can't provide a song that promotes or glorifies violence. It's important to seek help and support for victims of abuse. But you know this right here? This is a real song. It's a country song.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's so funny. I'll show you after a song that I was telling you about. It's like a country song.
The tractor is sexy kind of song?
Oh, yeah, wait in the truck. Yeah, watch.
Yeah, the tractor sexy? Yeah. Well, the country song.
It's called Wait in the Truck. Can you hear the lyrics?
Yeah.
Okay.
I like him already, homie.
Is this guy guy's fucking stupid, right?
Well, he's suing somebody.
Oh, let's see. Let's see what happens. Let's see. Open up, police.
Yeah. Right, knows him, too. His brother. Right. Is that Warren? Oh, shit. A wife beater with the wife beater on. Classic. Oh, man. Oh, shit. He's a shotgun.
Well,
shot him back in the head, though. That's how they got him.
Okay, well, you know what? The music video kind of makes it I never seen the music video. I just listened to it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and so, but this fucking idiot just saw a woman that was beat. And he's like, tell me where he's at. Kicks the door in. You don't even know if that's him. That could be the wrong thing. Like, she's in the truck and it's...
Well, first of all, who is she?
She's just a random stranger.
He doesn't know her.
He doesn't know her at all.
completely stranger.
Complete stranger.
In the street walking. And I thought he, like, I kind of felt like he knew her. Like
that's his sister or something.
Yeah, like it's from a childhood friend from high school or something. This and is... knew the guy, fucked her up. And I guess he fucking said, fuck this shit.
The no, these are two strangers. The woman's a stranger. And then the guy that he shot and killed in cold blood is a stranger.
Oh, damn. So it was the wrong guy?
No, it's the right. I mean, I'm sure it's the right guy, but I'm saying, like, what kind of fucking idiot does this? Like, she's in the truck, and it looks like he's in, like, a trailer park type of thing.
Yeah.
Like, dude, that could be the wrong guy. What if you just got the wrong guy, and you kicked the door in, right?
The cops get the wrong guys all the time, and that's cops.
That's
cops
true.
That investigate, supposedly, that supposedly stake out a place. They've killed veterans, by the way, because these fools go in the wrong house. The veteran is a little fucking, you know, off the edge and has guns.
He has guns. Well. And what do you do when someone kicks in your fucking door?
You shoot him fucking in.
Shoot them.
Ask questions later. You don't fucking get carried by 12. You get fucking judged by whatever, you know, judged by 12 instead of carried by 6.
Yeah.
So you just, you know, you gotta do your thing. But here, yeah, he fucking... kicks the door open, and luckily the guy didn't have a shotgun next to him or a gun.
Yeah. So you don't even know if this is the fucking guy. He just, like, or he killed somebody for a random woman that he doesn't even know. That he never know. Maybe it was her fault. Could be an idiot.
That might be a toxic relationship where she's gonna go back to him anyways.
Yeah. You risked your life.
I beat him, but
he goes
know.
To prison for life.
Yeah.
He's asking the Lord to have mercy on him.
She still goes to see him.
From time to time.
Yeah, so, you know, in between, you know what I'm saying?
So, like, once every...
Call on Tyrone.
She probably came to see him like once a month, once every 3 months, and then it started getting more. Okay, I'll come every once every year.
And then it faded into just writing.
Yeah, and then
ghosted.
Ghosted. She's not writing me back anymore, and that's not like I'm getting out.
And then she writes, and then she's inviting him to her wedding.
Look at my kids.
Yeah, there's a picture of the family.
Yeah, and then she's like, I'm leaving this guy, he's beating me. Like, I picked another winner.
Then he has to bust out of jail, right? He gets like an extra 10 years for that.
Yeah.
To go kill the other guy.
Is it me, or does this guy is this guy the biggest idiot in the world?
He definitely is if he shot the wrong guy.
But even if it's the right guy, like, you don't want to do that. You know what I mean?
Somebody beat on my sister, they're going to pay for it, bro. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah.
But that sister, not a stranger.
I understand that. Like, yeah. For me, I'm like, yeah, you know, he deserves to die.
Call the popo and stay out of the business.
Yeah.
As long as they don't come back. If it's happening in front of me, oh, yeah, you best believe I'm shooting a fucking cap on that guy.
Yeah.
I'm shooting a leg off for sure. I'm shooting a leg off first. Then I'm shooting his balls off. And if that don't stop him, then I'll tap on his chest, and then he definitely will stop.
Yeah, but anyway, I just thought this was a funny music video.
Hilarious.
Yeah, it's kind of stupid.
Oh, there she comes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He's like, I lived my job well done.
He was sitting here, and he's free, and he's paid. And yeah, some people make sacrifices, I guess. I don't know, man. Some people are very sacrificial like that. They don't care about their freedom.
Man, and you know what's funny is that, I mean, this might make you look at me like, God, this guy's a coward or something, but like me and my friend were walking around. We're adults already. We're probably like 19. And this guy was, I mean, he just looked like, I mean, he had wife beater too. Looked like straight up fucking thug.
That's girl. Beer stains and last night's lunch stains.
Exactly, like Mexican cholo looking guy. Like, you don't want to. It looks like he's on drugs, and he was beating the fuck out of a girlfriend. Like, she was on the curb. He was like beating her, and then,
the curb.
Yeah, like on the curb. Like, she was sitting on the curb, and he was like kind of wailing on her. And
damn.
So we're like, oh fuck, what the fuck? You like, and then my buddy's like, dude, like we should like, let's go, like, let's get in there. And I think he had a baseball bat. He's like, I could go get my baseball bat. And then, like, he was about to get ready to go into the action, you know, and I was like, I kind of like pulled on his shirt and I was like, bro, what the fuck are you doing? Like, I'm not gonna go with you. Like, I'm not gonna risk my life for this fucking girl. Like,
may have a gun on him, by the way.
I was like, dude, you don't. That's what I told him. I was like, dude, you don't know, he might have a fucking knife or a gun or something. Like,
would have to have the total upper hand on this motherfucker, like right behind him with a bat and knock his ass out.
Yeah.
Call the police, tell that girl to fucking run, and you go your way.
I mean, she just looked like, I'm not trying to be mean, but she looked like that's been her life. She's been through that. Like, that's a regular day for her. And I was like, bro, come on. That's her thing. Like, I'm not gonna. If she looked like a normal, upstanding citizen that looked like she was coming home from work, I would jump in. But he was like, oh, for real, you think? And like, I kind of convinced him not to do it. Yeah. And then he was like, all right. So we walked the other way. And then we went back like a couple minutes later and she was just like there.
And I've done something similar before when I went to Los Arcos nightclub out there in downtown, I think it was, with my brother. And it was his birthday.
Yeah.
So we went out as a guy's night out kind of thing. And we were in the parking lot. Some lady approached us, me, my brother, my compadre. And she was beat up. She had this fucking, and we were outside in the parking lot outside of the club. And she had this big ass black eye right here, bro.
Yeah.
And she was over here was like telling us, like, hey, I was like, I really love my husband, but he's like over there and I'm trying to get away from him. He's like, why are you talking to us? If your husband did that to you without regard, what do you think he's going to do to us talking to you?
I know,
He will come out here with a pistol and pistol whip us, or at least shoot us. And shit like that has happened at that club. So me and my brother were like, just get the fuck out of here before something else happens. This lady over here asking for our help, but then she's telling us that she really loves him and she really wants to stay with him, but she gets beat by him.
Okay.
Why? Call the police right now. And she didn't want to. I'm like, okay.
Okay, that's your problem.
What do you want us to do again?
Okay, that's good. I'm glad you said that, because like, ever since then, I kind of felt like,
no, oh, man.
I'm kind of cowardly, I guess.
It's not your family. You can do so much.
Yeah.
To help them. And I mean, sometimes just, I don't know. Revolving door between that relationship is like on and off, and you know, I mean, I've seen those too many times. I used to live, you know, in the apartments I used to live at, and some of them were like that, bro. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I think it's the same. Like, I just knew. I kind of thought of my buddy as like, man, what's wrong with him? He didn't think that through at all. Like,
well, he's Midoriya. He just wanted to jump in. He's MHA. He's My Hero Academia status.
Yeah. I mean, what are you going to do? Hit the guy with a bat and then you're going to, you know.
You for battery.
Yeah, now you're going to get in trouble because of this low-life guy. I mean, they looked bad, those guys.
And you would have to have film the proof that he was actively beating her while your friend hits him with a bat defending her.
Yeah.
Prove that, you hit him with a bat for a reason. If he comes back and she's gonna say, oh, I fell down the stairs, but that guy over there hit my husband with a bat.
Yeah, exactly. She's like protecting him.
He's on the scam, bro.
Yeah.
She could be in on the scam to get him to fucking confess to something, or to basically commit a crime and collect on the insurance or lawsuit. And dude, yeah.
Yeah, it was
assault and battery are, you know, suable assaults.
Yeah, and then you got this guy in this music video who meets a complete stranger and just, where is he at? I'll kick his door down and kill him for you.
Yeah, that was the bad thing, is that he kicked his door in. Been bad enough that he would have shot him outside his house, but it was bad enough that he did kick the door in, and, you know, he reached for his weapon, but he was in his house, so it was kind of asshole defense system. They have the right to defend themselves, right?
Yeah, it was.
No matter if they're wrong, actually. I mean, they have that Second Amendment right until they're a felon.
That's why I wrote,
if they're a felon, then ain't got no gun.
No, I'm mad that the AI didn't write me this song, even though it's a real song.
Well, song about selfless service. Chewing a wife beater.
Selfless service.
Well, you gotta think about it. He didn't think about himself, so I saw it called selfless service. Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Damn, it's 11:20.
I know, yeah. We've been going for 2 hours and 33 minutes.
A record.
This one's gonna be a doozy to edit. But
take it another day.
Yeah, another time.
Come up with some videos and more AI fun, I guess.
Yeah, let's come up with like some videos and we could just react to them and fuck around. I don't know.
Some upcoming movies so we can kind of critique on, and
yeah,
some anime chapters that came out or episodes. Have you been keeping up? I kept Boruto's back on manga anime. Fuck. So
I haven't even finished Naruto.
You haven't finished Naruto either?
No, I'm barely at the point where they're holding each other for like 4 episodes.
Jeez.
What's his name? The snake guy?
Oh man, you right at the beginning still.
Yeah. Yeah. I haven't watched it in like 3 years.
Fighting the third Hokage still.
I might go back to it.
Holding the sword and shit.
Yeah, that's why I was asking you if you had what is it? Like Crunchyroll or something like that.
Oh.
I was going to tell you, bro. I'll go halves with you. Split that in half. You had it.
And I use something called... Hold on, let's see.
I've been watching on 9 Anime.
That's where I watch it at, 9 Anime.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. Except Gantz was out of order. If you keep watching it, it's kind of lame.
It's, some of them are like glitchy. They don't load or...
Yeah.
Some of the more uncommon ones sometimes.
Do you plan on watching Gantz? Like... continue it or no?
Which one?
Gantz?
Is that the one with the killing?
Yeah, the aliens, like the little ball.
I mean, as soon as I get to it.
Oh, okay. I mean, like, did you like it? I guess that's what I mean. Like, did you like it enough to be like, yeah, I'm going to finish it?
Continuing it. I'm keeping up with these, I got to finish full freaking Attack on Titan. Also, final chapters came out, getting at it. So that one's going to finish this month, I think, or next month.
Yeah.
And
yeah, and you started The Last of Us too.
And I started The Last of Us, but I'll fit it in there somewhere. Like, yeah. I did start it when I got, you know, word of the 9 anime channel.
Yeah. I'm gonna watch Trigun all over again. That anime was tight.
Thunderbolt Lightning is the other one I'm kind of keeping an eye on.
That's an anime. What the heck? Nothing pops up.
It's Thunder. Hold on. Maybe I got it wrong. So my luck.
Oh, man. You should watch on Netflix. It's fucking cool, man. Oh, I love it. I wish they would come out with more. It's like about these superhero guys. It's kind of like The Boys, but in anime form. Yeah, it's not as...
Oh, Thunderbolt Fantasy, not Thunderbolt Lightning. Thunderbolt Fantasy. It's a puppeteer one, actually.
Oh, what the heck?
Pretty legit, bro. You got it, like, definitely check out at least one.
What the heck? That looks weird. Yeah. Is this how it looks?
Yes. And it's like, you don't see no strings. It's so fucking flawlessly done. It's so fucking badass, dude. And there's a character in there that reminds me of Jiraiya. Yeah. And he chiefs it. That's his weapon. He chiefs it and he exhales the smoke and he disables or basically roots his enemies because they're all dazed.
Whoa, this is kind of trippy looking.
You know what? They're dazed and he fucking like kicks the shit out of them. Yeah, the fight sequences, bro. Oh yeah, there it is. There he is. That's a dude, by the way.
I know, it looks like a chick.
So he fucking...
This is fucking funny.
It's with the chick too. She's like the princess, and they're kind of like escorting her back to her kingdom while all these weird assassins are trying to assassinate her. And this fool.
Please tell me there's an English dub.
Yeah, it's dubbed.
Oh.
It's dubbed. If you go on 9 Anime, it's dubbed for sure.
Dude, yep. This is like one of those things you smoke weed and watch.
Oh, man, what do you think?
Yeah, this is trippy.
Look at this.
Oh, man.
Flawless. And it's like fucking Firestone. Swords and shit.
Cool. That's pretty funny.
There's not just one. It's like another, like a second series. There's a movie. There's like a second series for it. It's like an expanded series.
Yeah.
I don't know. think I don't even know if this one ever got to like manga status, but it's definitely badass to watch.
Pretty cool, damn. I couldn't see myself watching it, but I might give it a try.
One episode, man, it'll hook you.
Yeah.
It's a bit, it's got comedy in it. It's kind of like, it reminds me, honestly, of like, what was that, Samurai?
Champloo?
Yeah. Kind of like that theme, but it's...
That's cool.
Samurai Champloo is badass.
Better. All right, man, I'm going to log off. I got to take a whiz.
I got to go work. I got to go to work in the morning.
Oh, shit, I know.
I got to commute 5 steps to my workspace.
You're already in there. Oh, yeah. That's funny.
Commute. Nah, but Tuesday, I do got to go back to the office. Yeah, if I can.
Poor guy.
Train people. All right, man.
Yeah, all right, man. Peace out, man.
Peace out.